When you think game of the year, you probably imagine something made in Unity, Unreal, or maybe even Godot. But what if I told you that one of 2024's biggest indie hits, Balatro, wasn't made in any of those? Nope. It was built using a tiny 2D engine called LÖVE. Yes, LÖVE with an
umlaut.
Umlaut. And believe it or not, it actually won Game of the Year at the DIGY Awards. So in this episode, let's take a quick look at this underappreciated gem. First off, LÖVE's been around for over 17 years. It's written in C++, it's totally free, and it's open source. But here's the catch, it only supports 2D, no 3D. For some people, that might be a deal breaker, but hold up, wait until you see the kind of stunning 2D games that are made with it. LÖVE is everywhere, I mean literally. It runs on all major platforms, including Linux and Android. See, LÖVE doesn't discriminate. Now, when I first downloaded it, I was kinda confused. I launched it and got this little balloon that just said no game. That's it. I thought, okay, cool. Where's the editor? How do I create a project? Did I open the wrong app? I even closed it and tried again, thinking maybe I messed something up. Turns out, if you want to work with LÖVE, you need to bring your own editor. Luckily, I had VS Code. But honestly, you could use something small as Notepad if you wanted. All that matters is the code you write. LÖVE doesn't care. All it wants is a folder with a file called main.lua. That's your entry point. It uses Lua for scripting, which is super lightweight and beginner friendly. Once you have got your folder and your main.lua file, you just drag and drop the folder on top of the LÖVE and boom, your game runs. We see a black window, because our main.lua file is empty. If you visit the official LÖVE site, you will find some simple code snippets. Let's copy paste one of them into our main.lua file and see what happens. Oops, an error. Looks like the whale image doesn't exist. Give it a second. And now we see a whale, just the head, but you get the idea. There's no built-in GUI here. Everything is LÖVE is done with Lua code. Now, if dragging and dropping every time feels like too much effort, don't worry. There's a great VS Code extension called LÖVE2D support. Install it, set the path to your LÖVE executable, and now you can just press Alt+L to run your project. So simple. Also, subscribing to this channel will be so lovely. Looking at the code, it's all pretty simple. The load function loads your asset and the draw function puts them on screen. You give it an asset, tell it where to go, and that's it. If you're curious, head over to the official LÖVE documentation. It's surprisingly well organized. The Getting Started section walks you through running your game, and at the bottom, you will find Next Steps, which will explain all the functions LÖVE offers, like draw to render stuff, or mouse release to do some actions when a user releases the mouse button, and so on. I also found this little open source game online called Fruit Crush. Basically Candy Crush, but made with LÖVE. I ran it and wow, it felt so smooth. The UI, the fruit animations, super responsive. And if you look at its folder structure, it's pretty typical for a LÖVE project. A folder for assets, one for libraries, another for source code, and of course, your main.lua file at the root. So yeah, under the hood, LÖVE is a game framework built on top of SDL2. It uses libraries like OpenGL, OpenAL, and LuaJIT to handle graphics, audio, and input, then exposes all of that through a simple Lua API. So, who is LÖVE really for? If you're into 2D games and enjoy coding, especially in Lua, you are gonna love it. But if you dream of making a 3D adventure game, forget it. Also, remember, there is no built-in editor, no visual scene graph, it's all code. So if you hate writing code or want something drag and drop, you might wanna look somewhere else. What are your thoughts on this? Have you tried LÖVE? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to hear your experience. Or you know, just drop a heart emoji. Some games made in LÖVE include Balatro. Of course, the game of the year that I have personally sunk way too many hours into. Then there's Move or Die, a chaotic multiplayer game, and ARGO. A Mesoamerican fantasy RPG.